الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستغفره ونستنصره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن سبحانه، وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن عظيمنا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أخوة الإيمان، طبتم وطاب ممشاكم، وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا. ثم أما بعد، نمضي وإياكم دقائق معدودة مع النبي الجليل إبراهيم عليه السلام. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every footstep he took toward this masjid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of us and make our place the highest place in Jannah. Allahumma ameen. We are going to spend a few moments with the great prophet, a great messenger, Ibrahim alayhi salam. When the time of Hajj comes, he cannot skip without talking about Ibrahim al-Khalil, nor his son Ismail alayhi salam. When Ibrahim alayhi salam left his wife Hajar and his newborn baby Ismail في واد غير ذي زرع كما أخبر المولى عن هذا الوضع. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the book, in a valley there is no way of life, there is nothing, desert. When he was leaving, she asked him one question. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you this order? He said yes. And she said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not let us go away. And she stayed with her son, a newborn baby. And what we do nowadays, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the Hajj, because of what Hajar did. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angel Jibreel alayhi salam and performed the miracle of Zamzam. Water, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Where nowadays a lot of Muslims, they don't have this little bit of water to drink. That's why we find them dying on the streets. When you look in Africa, particularly Somalia, you find people dying because they don't have a way to drink water. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam before the miracle of Zamzam. And it was a tribe called Jurhum. It was the true Arab tribe. They saw the water and they went. They asked Hajar alayhi salam, rahimahullah, can we stay here? My brothers and sisters, her answer is gonna, it makes you wonder. She did not say to them, yes, right away. Look what she said. You are welcome to stay under one condition. And they asked her, what is that? She said to them, you cannot act, you are the owner of the land. Mecca. Mecca, nowadays, you know, from the beginning, Hajar made a deal with those people. He cannot be the owner of Mecca. He cannot be the owner of the land. إنها مدينة الله. And they agreed on that. Ismail alayhi salam grew up, and Ibrahim used to visit his wife and his son. And of course, Ismail alayhi salam was part of the new tribe of Jurhum, and he get married from them. Ibrahim عليه السلام, he went to visit his son. When he arrived in Mecca, Ismail عليه السلام wasn't home. Knock on the door, the wife of Ismail opened the door. وكان إبراهيم عليه السلام رجل مهيب. إبراهيم, he was a very good looking man, even though he was old. But سبحان الله العظيم, when a person has darkness in his heart or her heart, cannot see anything beauty. والعياذ بالله. He knocked on the door, she opened. He asked her, where is your husband? She said, he's not here. He asked her about their life. And she went complaining. She started complaining. Subhanallah al-Azim, when you look at this story and you look at the situation of the Muslims nowadays, we do the same thing. You ask any person, how are you doing? Well, after a long line of complaining, then he will tell you, Alhamdulillah. In the end, he already complained because he's not satisfied. He or she is not satisfied. Even though we see that with our sisters nowadays. We find the husbands working day and night. They come home, they're not happy. They're not satisfied, no matter what they do. And that lady was exactly the same thing. She told them, we don't have enough money. And nowadays, that's what the Muslims, subhanAllah, say. We always don't have enough. She said, not enough food. Complain, complain, complain. And he said to her, when your husband comes back, say salam to him and tell him to change his front door. And subhanAllah al-Azim, when you look at this, the front door is always the wife. The wife is the front door of the house. If the Muslim lady practicing her religion, if she is covering her head, if she is practicing the meaning of La ilaha illallah, you find that's a Muslim's house. It changed your front door. He came and he asked her, what happened? Anybody comes, and that's what we usually do when we go to our houses. We ask our wives, what is going on? Anybody call? Any message? So he asked her. She told him it was an old man. Because of her heart was dark. She's not happy. And I told him about our situation. And he said, what did he say to you? He said, you know, to go ahead and change your front door. قال هذا أبي. He said, this is my father, إبراهيم عليه السلام, نبي الله. He said, هذا أبي. And he gave me direct order to leave you. And he divorced me. SubhanAllah, the second visit, إبراهيم went back to see his son, especially after the death of Hajar, رحمه الله. إسماعيل was lonely. You know, he felt bad because he lost his mother, so he remarried again. Ibrahim alayhi salam went to see his son. Not on the door. The lady opened the door. He asked her, where is your husband? She said, may Allah be with him. He is working. And he asked her, how was your life? She said, Allah, wa lillahi alhamd, our life is excellent. That's always what you hear from a Muslim, no matter what. No matter what, always he find the Muslim saying Alhamdulillah. When it comes to a Muslim woman, she's always happy and satisfied with the situation and say Alhamdulillah. And she said to him, Alhamdulillah, our life is great, it's good. She didn't compare her life to the other. She said, Awalillah, Alhamd, our life is good. Then he said to her, when your husband comes back, say salam to him and tell him to protect his front door and make it strong. He came, Ismail alayhi salam, and he asked her anything. She told him it was a very respected man. Light in his face. He said, salam to you. And he told you to take care of your front door. قال هذا أبي. This is my father, Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he gave me a direct order to keep you. And subhanAllah, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Those are the father and mother of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you look at his life, his line always appeared alayhi salatu wa sallam. From the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you look at his family line, you don't find any one of them was wrong. From the beginning, they were good people. Subhanallah al-Azim. Then Again, this time Ibrahim went back to Mecca. But with a mission, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him an order to build Al-Ka'ba al-Musharrafa. وكما أخبر المولى عز وجل إن أول بيت وضع للناس الذي في مكة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the first house was ever built on earth to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the one in Mecca. Because you know here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Mecca because people cry. Now that's why we feel our hearts going there. That's why, you know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a chance to go and visit His house, the first thing we do, we cry. Even if we see it, if we see Mecca, we cry on TV. Even when we hear somebody is coming back, and we hug them and we cry. That's why it was called Mecca. Look at this miracle, revive in front of our eyes. He told him, he went back to Mecca, started looking for his son, he found him, and he hugged him. And I wish, if I can see the Muslims nowadays, say they doing the same thing with their fathers. Subhanallah, nowadays we find a lot of us saying the old man. The old man. That's how we use that term nowadays. We have to respect our brothers, our fathers. And the fathers need to respect their kids. It's two-way street, my brothers and sisters in Islam. He told him, oh my son, ya Ismail, لقد أمرني الله بأمر عجيب. Subhanallah العظيم. Even you know Ibrahim, he was wondering. He said, oh my son, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give me an order. And this order, I'm wondering about it. قال وما ذاك يا أبي؟ قال إن الله أمرني بأن أبني له بيتا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give me an order to build a house for him. And he pointed at the place where like a little hill, you know, dust around that, he said right there. And he was wondering, but Ibrahim alayhi salam, even though he was an old man, even though he never refused the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you look at the prophets and the messengers, and you look at the sahaba, and you look at the true Muslims, they never refused the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not matter of the age. But nowadays we find ourselves complaining. We are too old to stand. We are too old to pray. We are too old to walk and good deeds. We always complain. And look at Ibrahim alayhi salam. He was an old man, but he walked to fulfill the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ أَتُعِينُنِي وَهَذَا إِسْمَعِيلَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Ibrahim to sacrifice his son, and Ismail, he was 10 years old back then. قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ إِفْعَلْ مَا تُمَّرْ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. You know, back then when the order was to kill him, he said, oh my father, do it. And you find me amongst the patient. Now the same guy, when he is an older guy, when he is a man and his father is asking him for another help, he said, yes, we'll do it. And that, my brothers and sisters tell us, you know, when you come to the masjid, bring your son with you. When you want to do something good, take your son with you. Be an example to your son. Be an example to yourself. Be an example to your society. Because we are Muslims and we are here on this earth to build the earth. It's not like what they say about us, and we wait, you know, when there is something, a movie or a piece of news, here we get mad. We should not get mad. We should prepare ourselves. We should prepare ourselves to stand, because every now and then we're going to hear a new law for us, made especially for the Muslims. ولكن we must obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأن نرجع إليه. We go back to Him, does not matter what, and we need to do our part. And 9/11 was the part of La ilaha illallah. People start looking and asking about Islam because we were, you know, sitting back. We change our names, we change our identity, we change the way we look. So when that happened, we get scared. We start getting worried. We didn't do it. We didn't do it. But subhanallah al-azim, that it was a way, it turned the bad thing to be a good thing, and people start asking about Islam. And 60,000 convert to Islam. Because we don't understand how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala work. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. This is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to mankind. So that's why, and when you see something bad, say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, because you don't know if it is bad or good. Be patient. And now we can see the other part of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, they made a movie, but what we did, we jumped and we started, you know, to see what they are talking about. And we forget we are a Muslim, should be away from that. But you hear people saying, let's see what they have to talk about. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ. Anybody make fun of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cannot reach that. No one. إِنَّهُ مُحَمَّد sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibrahim, he started building Al-Ka'bah al-Musharrafah with his son, doing tawaf at the same time, you know, building Al-Ka'bah, stone after another. When the wall get little bit higher, they can't reach it anymore. He said, oh my son, can you bring me a stone to stand on it to reach a little bit higher? And he did. وَهَذَا مَقَامَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. When inshallah, some of you already went, inshallah the rest of us will be there. عَلَى صَعِيدَ عَرَفَاتِ. You know, inshallah we might, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring all of us to be there and make it, you know, two rak'at to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala next to the place of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he start building while they are building Al-Ka'bah, fulfilling the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were making a dua to Allah azza wa jal. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا فهي الفوز المستغفر. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى التابعين وتابعي التابعين وعلى من سار على نهجهم إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد إخوة الإيمان, we find the two prophets fulfilling the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the same time making dua to Allah Azza wa Jal to accept their good deed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded that. They said, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. You see, subhanallah al-azim, you know, it didn't say, well, you give us the order, we're gonna do it. Alhamdulillah, we did something good because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us. No, my brothers and sisters in Islam, even when you do something good, you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your deed, to accept your prayer, to accept your sadaqat, to accept your fasting, because you don't know if you did it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for something else. وَهَذَا مِنْ تَمَامَ الْعِبَادَةِ. You want to complete worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have a good example, which is Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam. They were doing the order of Allah azza wa jal. At the same time, they were asking Allah azza wa jal to accept their good deed. رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَهُ. Oh Allah, give us the total submission to you. And that's another lecture, my brothers and sisters in Islam. When we hear قال الله تعالى, we should obey that with no question asked. سَمَعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us. When we hear, when you have an order, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said something, your answer should be, yes, I hear and I obey. That's the meaning of total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا. From our offspring. That's another job on us, my brothers and sisters in Islam. We need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only to make us a nation, no, from our offsprings too. And we need our kids to be Muslims because this is our responsibility. We cannot force them la ikraha fi din, but we can show them the right way, and the right way is to start with ourselves. بِأَبْدَىٰ بِنَفْسِكِ. أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً. Whole nation to you, O Allah. وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا. Even though, you know, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show them their way how to worship Him Azza wa Jal. That means there is one way only to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's according to the teaching of the prophets, not according to common sense. not according, you know, what you feel like, according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal said. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا. Not only that, they didn't stop right there. And they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And that's what we don't do, my brothers and sisters in Islam. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي. We feel sometimes when we come to the masjid and pray, like we are doing favor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has given us a great bounty by giving us a chance to come over here and worship Him azza wa jal. I advise myself and the rest of you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to His order azza wa jal. And I advise myself and the rest of you to open our hearts and depend on Allah azza wa jal, to be just a true Muslim in our daily life at 24/7. Don't let your iman to be a switch. You turn it off and you turn it on when anytime you feel like it. Be a Muslim at 24/7. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, who is, what is the definition of a Muslim, or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at his reply, man salima an-nasa min yadihi wa lisani. You know, the people who live in peace from his hand and his tongue. That's the way we should be. And we need to defend our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by following his akhlaq. It is in Urdu and Arabic. His morals. We need to be. Tell the people about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have a chance to tell them, to tell the others. Ibrahim alayhi salam, huwa abu al-anbiya. He is the father of Ismail and the father of Ishaq. He is the father of the prophets. The old belief and la ilaha illallah. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I came to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me this opportunity to look at your lovely faces and to tell you very quickly about the small foundation exists in Somalia, and the president of that foundation is a brother Abdullah, the person you know. In Somalia, my brothers and sisters in Islam, it's not only war, but also they have orphans, they have widows. They cannot have water because there is no clean water. Not to take a shower, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Not to enjoy the clear water while they are eating. Just to stay alive, a little bit of water to stay alive. A little bit for a mother to feed her newborn baby. Always remember the story of Ismail, so you can see and understand your brothers and sisters in Somalia looking for help. They asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here, and look at us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us something very important, my brothers and sisters in Islam. إِنَّ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ وَالْمُصَدِّقَاتِ وَأَقْرَضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا. Look, the musaddiqeen, the one who they gave charity. Not only that, they gave a loan to Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَهُوَ سُبْحَانَهُ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. You know, he gave a loan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا يُضَاعَفُ لَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply that for them. وَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ كَرِيمٌ. And on top of that, not only they see that in their family, they don't see that in their own money, no, and also there is a reward for them at the top, and the top of that. Brothers and sisters in Islam, sometimes when we come to a masjid and we see a khatib, we say, Ya Allah, that's another fundraising. And then if we go to another masjid, some of the mashayikh also they do fundraising. When we see their faces, we run away. Are you praying to them or are you praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we going to give charity to them or to Allah azza wa jalla? We need, if we do fundraising on daily basis, it's not enough. Because if you look at our countries, if you look at Pakistan, at Syria, at Yemen, at Somalia, Nigeria, any Muslim countries, you find the Muslims are suffering. 2 weeks ago, the Muslims were suffering in Pakistan of the flood. We also, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, the other organization, ICNA, helped them. And before that, it was a disaster area in Louisiana. Also Muslims and non-Muslims were suffering. Walillahi alhamdulillah, ICNA was there also helping the people. Anywhere you look, my brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to help each other. We are one ummah. This is the dua of Ibrahim and Ismail. They ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send the prophet and messenger amongst them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وهو القائل. And he said to us, he said to his ummah, أنا وكافل اليتيم كهاتين. If anybody support an orphan, I am with them in Jannah like this. In Jannah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your companion is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we all know the hadith of as-sadaqa al-jariyah. But imagine, my brothers and sisters in Islam, while we are sitting here, or going to work, or anywhere else, sitting with our family, with our kids, and there is a little boy in Somalia, find a clear water, and he raised his hand to heaven, and he said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, may Allah reward the one who made this water clear for me. And the hasanat will be working while we are sitting here. But you see, you should not do it for the hasanat. You should do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your target, it should be higher, not only to enter paradise, no, the highest place in paradise. And then when you enter paradise, you want to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما قال وَلِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُ الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَ. The one who did good, the paradise for them. And look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجُوهُنْ يَوْمَ إِذِ النَّاظِرَةِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا النَّاظِرَةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ عَظِيمٍ بدأه نفسه ثم تن عليه بالملائكة خطي حيث قال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وبارك